Hello and hi everyone! Welcome back to our third video in this Wano Let's Play series. I know you may be wondering, why am I wearing this heart hat? That's because in today's video, we're gonna do a bunch of terraforming. I realized in between this video and last video that my layout for Amigasa Village is not correct. Amigasa Village should be way, way down here. For some reason, I thought there was another town below Amigasa Village, and that is just, that is incorrect. So we're gonna be moving as much of our trees and bamboo as we can today, terraforming a new cliff for Otama's house, and then we're gonna be expanding the wastelands as it properly should be quite large. So without further ado, let's get into it. First, we're gonna need to get lots of food to eat so that we can pick up all the trees and the bamboo and shimmy it on down further south. Let's grab some coconuts because I don't have any fruit on my trees today. And we're back with a full belly. Now that we've got our food in our system, let's go ahead and grab these bamboo trees and pine trees. My shovel! Oh no! Well, that didn't last very long. Guess we need another one. Shovel, please. And we're back. I really hope I don't have to move all of these trees again. This is very tedious. Dang it, I'm short a few coconuts. Okay, these three trees are gonna have to wait to move. I've roughly sketched out the elevated terraformed area where Otama's house is gonna go, so let's just place our trees kind of sporadically through here. This is supposed to be a bamboo forest, so we are gonna make these trees pretty dense. I do need to leave space to make sure that there are other, like, broken down things in the village. I'm definitely gonna need to get more bamboo at some point, because I am running a little low. My bamboo trees haven't really been sprouting any roots, which is kind of unfortunate, because I was banking on getting lots of bamboo roots and replanting them to just grow more trees. But it seems like we're gonna need to, I don't know, maybe go on some Nook Mile islands to find more bamboo. I'm feeling lazy about moving this last hardwood tree, so we're just gonna chop it down. Okay, I think this is looking pretty good. We've got the area outlined by all of these pine trees and bamboo trees. I picked the pine trees just because I think they are a little more foresty than the hardwood trees. Also, at the time of year we're gonna save this dream address in, the hardwood trees are hopefully all gonna be cherry blossom trees, and I don't want any cherry blossom trees in this area, so let's go ahead and finish terraforming this area. And we're done! I wanted to make it similar to the size of the other platform that I had made in the previous Amigasa Village, but I also wanted to make this one a little bit larger so I could fit some more trees on the top of these cliffs. Now let's go talk to Tom Nook and move Otama's house up on top. Hey buddy! And we're done! I'm gonna go ahead and skip to the next day because I want this house to be moved and I want to get rid of this bridge. So I will see you soon. Welcome back to the next day. I know what you're thinking. I know what you're thinking. Very unique look I have on. I kind of wanted to channel the gifters today and I don't have that black eye mask yet. So we're just gonna go with an eye patch and, you know, it's just a mood. Now that it's the next day, we have Otama's house finally moved. Let's go check it out. Ah, it looks so good up there. I'm so much happier with how this is than the previous Amigasa Village. Let's collect this fossil and then get rid of this terraforming so we can expand the wasteland. Wow, this outfit looks significantly worse now that I'm wearing the construction hat and not my sheep hat. You know, you could say I'm channeling my inner Mary because Mary's got the sheep head figure. And we're done with the terraforming. That went a lot faster than I thought it was going to. Let's get out of this Island Designer app because I don't like this construction hat. I want my sheep head back, thank you very much. We're definitely gonna need to make some more spiky fencing. I kind of like the spiky fencing for the wasteland area because it makes it look like we're not supposed to be here. It's not a nice area. It's, I don't know, it just kind of fits the vibe. Ugh, you know, I just realized we need to pull the construction app back out because we need to put all of that pathing down to make this wasteland area. Now I'm sad. All right, here we go. that the wasteland is all filled in, which took forever, let's craft some more dead trees and other items to spruce up the area. And let's go place them on the land. Some of you may have seen my character's name in the last video. I know it's spelled Otoma instead of Otama, and this is actually not a mistake. This was intentional. When I first started this island, I let my fiance design and name my character, and that is why my character is named Otoma and not Otama, because my character is not Otama. It's a different person in the world of One Piece. We just, you know, we use our imaginations, we pretend. Let's go see what other items we have to add to this area. We might have to order some from Nikuzan, but that's okay because off camera I spent a lot of time grinding for bells. So we are pretty stocked at the moment on money. I'm pretty sure at this point we can buy whatever we need to fill up this area. Okay, yeah, we really don't have much in our storage to fill this area out. So let's head to Tom Nook and see what we can order online. All right, what do we have today? Nothing, no special items that I'm really interested in. Okay, let's see what we have in here that would be good for the wasteland. Let's order a cardboard box to throw some kind of junk items in there. Let's grab a metal pot. Ooh, a skeleton might be fun. All right, that's all we're gonna order for now. It's not as much as I was expecting, but that's okay. I do have an idea for something else that we could add. Since the start of this island, I've been checking the Able Sisters every day to see if she has animal costumes. And that's not only to try and put out these items to imitate the gifters that are in One Piece, but also because there are these giant animals in the wasteland, and I wanted to put out some of these items to mimic that. Let's grab some gyroid fragments to really add to the death. Pockets are full. Yeah, I guess I do have a lot of stuff in my pockets. Let's try and fix this. Okay, so we'll place up what we have first. We're gonna put down this plain wooden shop sign for now. I'm going to customize it with like a beware or keep out sign in the future, but for now we're just gonna throw that down to remind myself that that's an item I want to have here. We'll place a floor sign. A lot of the decorating in this wasteland is gonna feel random. And that's because it is random, you know? It's not supposed to be a nice, well put together area, you know? It's supposed to be the wasteland. It's deserted. We're gonna throw down these animal ears to represent one of the animals that's living here. We'll also throw down this fox mask to be another one of the giant animals that live here. There are rivers with poison fish in the wasteland, so I think we should add a little bit of waterscaping just to show that there are rivers here. Alright, that looks pretty good. We're gonna turn this hat now to pretend that this animal is drinking from the water. My goals for the next parts of this island are to clear out this area below the town hall here. I don't have the most space on this island, like I've said before, so we're kind of modifying the layout of Wano to make sure that we can fit the more key areas of Wano itself. What we'll probably be doing is turning this area over here into a very small udon prison camp. We'll extend the waterscaping down south here, and we'll make Ebisu Village right below Town Hall here. I'd also like to work on clearing all of these cliffs away and getting rid of them. I spent some time off camera getting rid of all the trees and the flowers on the top of these cliffs, so all that's left to do is just demolish them, and then we can start working on the northern graveyard area of Wano. I think that's gonna be it for today's video. I know it was kind of a shorter one, but this week has been honestly really busy for me. I'm moving to a new apartment this week, so it's kind of been a little crazy, and I think I just need to be I need to be done with it here. I truly hope you enjoyed watching today's video. If you did, be sure to give that like button a hit, give that subscribe button a hit. I'd love to see you around more on my channel. I hope you have an amazing day wherever you are, whoever you are. You deserve the best. Thank you again so much for being here. Bye-bye!